Did you see any of the Monty Python shows? They just got back together at the O2.
I was in it. Yeah. I was in it.
What'd you do?
I was in it because I met Eric years ago now, and we got into a debate about the Galaxy song, because he wrote the Galaxy song, which is all loads of facts about the universe. And he said to me, as Robin said earlier, he said, the thing is that I get loads of emails now because you scientists have changed it all. So since I wrote it, so I was in the meaning of life, and you've changed all the numbers, and I get loads of things saying, you're not right, you were wrong. And so we rewrote it together. I said, well, let's change it. So we changed all the things. And the Python shows, he did the original one. And then there's a video afterwards comes up of me saying, well, of course, this is factually incorrect. When it says the Earth orbits at 90 miles a second around the sun, that presupposes that it's a circular orbit. In fact, it's elliptical, so it would be better to... And I just go off on this. And as I'm doing that, there's a little dot in the distance coming towards me. And I'm at King's College in Cambridge. And there's a little dot comes, and it gets bigger and bigger and bigger. Really Python-esque approach. And it turns out it's Stephen Hawking in his wheelchair, absolutely caning it down the road. And he runs me over, knocks me into the river, basically, and says, I think you're being a bit pedantic. And then he starts singing the Galaxy song and then takes off into the galaxy. And so that's part of the O2 show. So it's me being a pedant and getting run over by Stephen Hawking.
That must have got a tremendous response.
It got a big laugh, because you can't see what it is. You think there's something coming that's going to hit him. I don't know what it is. And it turns out it's Stephen. And he did it. He's a big Python fan. Actually, Eric Idle had said to me, because he knew that I'd met Stephen before and I sort of knew him a bit, and he said to me, can you email him and just see if he'd be up for doing a gag at the O2? And so I emailed him, and within a minute an email came back saying yes, straight away. I got back to Eric and said, yeah, he said yes. He's like, what? He said,
that's pretty cool.
He said yes.
We had another one when we did a show in Hammersmith at the Hammersmith Apollo. We got The Cure as our guest band, which was like incredible. And then the show ended with The Cure and Eric Idle doing Always Look on the Bright Side of Life. And you know those little moments where you go, some of these pointless artistic endeavours, but some of just the excitement of seeing, because Robert Smith's a keen amateur astronomer. That's what I love, is some of these people who think, well, what's Robert Smith? Why would he say yes or send him an email? Oh, yeah, it'd be great to stand at the side of the stage and talk about different constellations.
That's pretty cool. Yeah. I got to ask you about Stephen Hawking. Did you see Theory of Everything?
I haven't seen it yet.
Oh, I would think you would see.
I've heard it's great.
Yeah.
And how is Stephen doing these days?
He's very well, actually. He came to the last Python show at O2, actually, and he enjoyed it very much. And he was sort of holding court backstage afterwards, like the true rock and roll legend that he is. Anyway, so people big queue to come to see him, and he's very well.
Reasons why I find that song scientific. It's pathetic, really. The statement that the sun is the source of all our power, well, take geothermal energy. That comes from the heat of the Earth's core. That's generated at least in part by the radioactive decay of uranium. Uranium was formed in supernova explosions. And then the statement that the Earth orbits at 19 miles a second. Well, that'd be okay if the Earth's orbit was circular, but in fact it's elliptical. So it's better to say that the Earth sweeps out equal areas in equal times. Kepler knew that back in 1609. Then the statement that space-time expands at the speed of light. Well, there was a period of expansion, exponential expansion, between 10 to the minus 36 and 10 to the minus 32 seconds after the Big Bang, called inflation. In which
I think you are being pedantic. Just remember that you're standing on a planet that's evolving, and you're evolving at 900 miles an hour. That's orbiting at 19 miles a second, so it's reckoned. The sun that is the source of all our power. The sun and you and me and all the stars that we can see are moving at a million miles a day. In an outer spiral arm at 400,000 miles an hour, in a galaxy we call the Milky Way.